Hey everybody, this is Mr. Rock, and today we are going to do an introduction to cells. In order to begin this learning, we first have to define what a cell is. A cell is essentially a basic unit which is going to make up all living things. So whether it is plants, animals, fungus, protists, bacteria, no matter if it is a living thing, it's going to be made up of cells. A place that we would want to start then is who was the first person to discover what a cell looks like. This man's name was Robert Hooke. He was an English biologist and he first discovered what a cell looks like back in 1665. So he was using a compound microscope just like we use in class, and what he discovered were these little rectangles, and he essentially thought they looked like little tiny gel cells. Actually, little tiny rooms that were stacked against each other, and that's actually how they got their name cells. About 150 years later, or in 1838, some biologists worked together to develop this thing called the cell theory. The cell theory states three main premises for what a cell is. So number one, all living things are composed of cells. Number two would be cells are the basic units of structure and function in living things. Number three is new cells are produced from existing cells. So all the new cells that are constantly generated in your body, they are coming from existing cells. So no new cell is just spontaneously created. It comes from an existing cell. So there are a lot of different cells on our planet, and what we are going to now do is we're going to define just what two different cells look like and what they are. So the two biggest categories of cells that are different would be prokaryotes versus eukaryotes. We're going to start with prokaryotic cells because they deserve to start first, because they were the first cell that was what we believe to ever be on this planet. So prokaryotic cells, they are very, very simple. They're very basic, not very complex. They do not have a nucleus. They do not have any membrane-bound organelles. So in our cells, human cells, we are not prokaryotes. But in human cells, we have mitochondria, and we have lysosomes, and we have all these complex organelles. Prokaryotes don't have any of those complex structures inside their cells. So they don't have any mitochondria. They don't have any of those organelles that perform functions. Since they are more simple, they can be capable of movement. So prokaryotes typically can move around on their own because they are always unicellular. So a living organism can be just made up of one cell, and that's what we have here as a prokaryote, only made up of one cell, and that's why they need movement. An example of this would be bacteria. There's a lot of different bacteria. E. coli, Salmonella, I put two pictures here of bacteria. One is an illustration, and then one's actually like kind of a cool image. So we are eukaryotes. You are a eukaryote. The big differences are between the prokaryote and the eukaryote. The eukaryote has a true nucleus. So it has a nucleus. This is a place where all of the DNA for that cell is contained. That's a big difference. Another big difference is that we eukaryotes, eukaryotic cells, they have membrane-bound organelles. So this is what I was referring to earlier. Golgi apparatus, mitochondria, lysosomes, all of these complex structures that are found within the cell that help the cell to perform functions. Eukaryotes have those. For that reason, eukaryotic cells are typically more complex and more specialized. They can either be unicellular or multicellular, and a lot of the living things that you know today are eukaryotic. So plants, animals, you don't know what a protist is. It's a small, single-celled organism. An example would be like an amoeba, but pretty much everything you know that is living would be classified as eukaryotic. Two things I just want to give definitions to would be what a unicellular thing is. So I said that prokaryotes are unicellular, and these things are single-celled organisms They're only one cell big, and it meets all characteristics of life. So these things could either be eukaryotic or prokaryotic. All prokaryotes are unicellular. Eukaryotic can either be unicellular or they can also be multicellular. Multicellular is a living organism made up of many cells. Like I said earlier, these cells typically exhibit some type of specialization or complexity. So they're more complex than the unicellular organisms. And these are found only in eukaryotes. So the last term that we really need to define today is what cell specialization is, and this is only found in eukaryotic cells. The definition reads, cells throughout an organism can develop in different ways to perform different tasks. So we see this a lot in eukaryotic cells, and I'm going to just use examples from the human body because that's probably what we're most familiar with. We have muscle cells. Your muscle cells are used to move things, lift things, pull things. They're great for carrying out movement, kinetics. You have nerve cells that communicate with the rest from your body to your brain and your brain to your body back and forth. So nerve cells are used in communication. And red blood cells deliver oxygen all throughout your body. So all of these different cells are different and they are designed specifically to perform a specific task. And this is cell specialization, and this is only seen in eukaryotic cells. Thank you for listening today. Hopefully all this made sense, and please ask me if you have any questions.